Emily!
At times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
Stop!
Zach, did you see that? I must be getting tired. Zach, looks like we're out of the countryside and back in civilization.
Welcome, York.
I brought the documents.
Just what is going on in here?
I warned you about haste. Take it slow. You'll lose sight of what's important if you just rush past it. As an agent of the FBI, I'm sure you know. So many people have got it all wrong. They think speed is the key. That being first is the best. They want speed. Satisfied with what the speed brings, even if it means that they miss so much on the way, they don't even see that. I see everything that they don't. From here, I see it all. Then, when the time comes, I make use of what I've seen. I can get whatever I want in this way, anything at all.
Certainly talkative today, Harry. But I didn't come here for a business lecture. Tell me everything you know.
Speed is not important. Timing is what is important. Timing. York, you have a natural gift for waiting for the correct timing. Just be careful that your haste does not ruin everything. That will be vital to solving the current case at hand. York, I know more than you think, but less than what you hope. One, you have taken custody. Two, Thomas is missing. Three, Carol has a locket that belongs to the murderer. I also know that this case revolves around the Red Seeds. But that's about it.
So you've got an inside line on police information.
That reminds me. The victim's tongues were cut out, weren't they? But that's only a minor point. Don't let the shocks blind you to what's more important. That's another business tip.
Harry, I'm impressed. You gather information really well. You hacked into the FBI network, too. Amazing. But I didn't come here to hear this.
Then let us close the business seminar. It's time for a history lesson instead. I remember it as though it were yesterday. Disturbing sound. The following morning, I awoke surrounded by dead bodies. It wasn't raining anymore, and the purple fog was gone. I couldn't believe what I saw and what I myself had done. But even worse things were waiting for me when I got home. My mother was dead. Killed, presumably, also by my father. The next day, the town was overrun by military personnel. That's when the gag order was issued. Talking about the incident was unappreciated, a taboo. But even still, people stopped going outside when it rained. Country folk are very patriotic. We never tell our children about what happened. But these things find a way out of even the tightest of lips, in parts. People only speak of the killer in the red raincoat, which is where the legend of the raincoat killer comes from.
Quite a story.
After the incident, the gas seeped into the soil of the town. Even today, when it rains, a minute amount is released. That's why I never take my mask off when I'm outside. This town is dirty, York.
If what you say is true, then the killer is someone who is badly affected when it rains.
You need to draw the conclusions, not I. I have no conclusions.
Is there a connection between the red seeds and the gas, then?
This is just my own presumption. The seeds and the gas have a similar effect on our nervous systems. I believe someone figured that out and decided to use it. Or it could just be nature's way of getting back at us humans.
You one thing then, Harry. You're a businessman. You must be after something in return for giving me this information.
York, at times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
That still does not justify murder.
Remember this. Everything changes in form. There isn't a single thing that can maintain its shape for
York, we found Thomas.
Ah, he's at his house, right?
How did you know that?
Timing, Emily. Good timing.
Whatever, just get in. George is heading over there already. Let's get a move on.
That was for Thomas to fill in the blanks in our new legend.
George, what's happening?
You received an anonymous call informing us that Thomas returned home. I sent Emily to get you right away.
No idea who made the call?
No. That's why I came on ahead, to see if the information was correct. A light did come on, but only for a second. I saw a tall male silhouette in the window. It was Thomas.
Okay. I'm going in. You two wait here.
We'll be ready to burst in at any moment. Just call out.
Zach, It's the same in the countryside after all. The climax of an investigation is always in an apartment. Noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.